modules in training nila bang hitadihin na maripa pa mga participants na yung nakakato. Most especially, magbisara sila, bisara ang galis, English. So, di resep kahatian sin kay banan mga mayor. So, what a waste of money, what a waste of time in attending this conference, utilizing public funds for their transport and registration in the seminars in the amount of 50 to 70,000, looking pa yung pocket money, pag-uos siya to utility. Local Government Code or the new ARMM Local Government Code in the ARMM is specifically designed to suit the local government units need in their administration. Gingatan mo brother Raup, in National Local Government Code tabihaon amon na tag na ito ang implemental version mataud di magkugdan even sin kalagihan tadi ha ARMM because you know we are enjoying autonomy here, so therefore there is a need for our local government specifically designed based from the societal norm in the region and as well as the cultural perspective of our people. In the local government code of the ARMM, it passed, which is under my committee, the Committee on Local Government, is specifically designed to develop as much as possible its administrative aspect, the technological know-how of the local government executives. Kaya ngatan mo mataod, mayor ta magkalagihan na isang technical know-how. Instead of criticizing them, we really have to assist them. There is the existence of this so-called ARMM Local Government Academy. Amuyawon in Bayata Itap in order to assist these local government executives from the mayor to the vice mayor to the members of the Sangguniang Bayan, including our thousands of barangay chairman in the 116 municipalities in the entire region. And this is the very reason why we crafted the new ARMM Local Government Code. There was this so-called ARMM Local Government Code which was passed by the 6 RLA. Among sadya, there are around 168 sections that must be amended. So, we decided, specifically my committee, the Committee on Local Government, decided that there shall be a introduction or the crafting of a new ARMM Local anyway, Government.
To sum it up, for regards to the two inputs, we really have a lot of problems as far as our local government unit is concerned. Aside from the availability of IRA to some municipalities, aside from the issue on the creation and abolition of these municipalities, we also have a very serious problem confronting our local government units. Aside from their absences. In other words, that specific problem, I should say, and let it be on record. But of course, we cannot blame them because we are mandated and they are elected. Yung mga mayors na medyo hindi namin na nakakaintindi ko anong ibig sabihin ng local government code. This is very ironic, but this is true. In the municipalities of so-and-so, yung mayor ay hindi rin nakakaintindi ng Ingles. Attending seminars, conferences in Manila, using public funds, in going to the conferences, in a 2 to 3 days conference, what a waste of money, what a waste of time, hindi rin naman maintindihan ang inputs, then going to their, back to their municipalities, wala rin maibahagi sa tao nila. But of course, we cannot claim them because we are elected. We are mandated by law to execute their power as the local executive. The very reason why I'm stating this and other problems to my committee members is that there is our local government academy. There is the ARMM Local Government Academy. I just don't know if it's a system. And these are the very institutions who must be able to revitalize in order to educate these leaders of ours in the local government units. Mahirap eh. There are 160 mayors and 40% of that are not familiar with the local government code. And around 20% of that, hindi man parang nakakaintindi ng English. We have around 115 vice mayors kasi yung isa medyo out of the 116, yung isa medyo may problema pa. We also have around 1,200 members of isang Union Bayan na kinakailangan din ng education and the necessary trainings with regards to parliamentary procedures, committee hearings, the usage of other different committees in their asambunian. We also have around 7,600 barangay chairman in the ARMM na kinakailangan natin ng education. This is a challenge for this committee. So at this juncture, may we hear from the representative of the Philippine National Police, sir?
Well, in 116 mayors in the ARMM will be in attendance. So with the, of course, the president will be there. Our regional governor will also be there. Plus 27 members of the RLA will also be invited to join that local government summit. Purpose of which is to, of course, to formulate some plans for the next few years with regards to the local government sector. Dahil marami tayong problema sa local government units. In fact, karamihan ng ating mga observer ngayon sa ARMM, palagi ang focus sa ARMM leadership. When in fact, mismo yung number one stakeholder sa ARMM is the local government unit, hindi lang naman ARMM leadership eh. You know? So dapat natin i-focus yung sitwasyon sa local government units, hindi lang sa ARMM leadership. Alam niyo, maraming problema, and I'm not hesitant to say it. Ilan lang bang mayors dito sa ARMM na pumupunta sa kanilang munisipyo? How can you effectively manage your the leadership in your municipalities pag ikaw mismo nakatira dito sa Sampuanga, nakatira sa Manila, nakatira sa Cagayan de Oro City? So, ilan lang ba porsyento sa mga munisipyo natin sa ARMM na mayroon Municipal Peace and Order Council? Almost 30% niya. How can you preserve the peace and tranquility in your municipality pag mismo yung head of the municipality wala doon sa kanilang munisipyo? The same thing with barangay chairman. How many of those municipalities na walang municipal education board that shall look into the educational situations and education programs in the different municipalities? Siguro mga 10% lang. Paano kasi pag si mayor oras ng sweldohan, hindi mo matatagpuan? Treasurer accountant, hindi mo rin matatagpuan. How can you strengthen leadership in the different municipalities kung wala ka doon? This is the primary problems confronting the local government units. At inaasahan ito by June 2021 because the first day will be there, the second day will be all the members of the area will be in attendance. Ipo-formulate din doon. As far as our committee is concerned, we are now working hand in hand with the Secretary of the DILG-ARMM for the strengthening of the local government units. Sa committee level po namin, nagpo-formulate na kami ngayon ng mga possible na dapat gawin for the next few months, no? Which include the revenue enhancement. Maskin yung NTC, may problema rin tayo. Sa dami-dami ng tower ng ating telecommunication, hindi rin nagre-remit ang local government units sa ARMM. Mga ganong tipo ba? But instead of telling this mayor na medyo pagsabihan natin, ititrain na lang sila, we have this ARMM Local Government Academy. Dapat natin i-strengthen ito, ma-localize yung training enhancement. No? Ganon din ang mga pangyayari ng mga nakaraan. Tatawagin yung mayor para mag-seminar sa Manila, tapos hindi rin maintindihan ng ang mga lecturer galing sa Pilipinas because they speak in English. So, i-localize na lang natin yung training. Invest na yung model nila Quezon City. Ang model na lang development module natin ay Albarca or other municipalities. Paano malaman ng mga lecturer ng taga-UP yung problema ng municipality tulad ng Albarca? So, i-localize natin. Barangay officials, ang estudyante ay nagabasilan. Yakan ang lecturer. We have here local government expert. Katulad ni Nasim Limanhang, ang dami dyan. Pag maranaw ang mayors, maranaw din ang mag-electure. In other words, localized. Kasi ilan lang naman ang head of office natin na nakakaalam kung anong essence ng local government code. Mga vice mayor natin, how to preside over a meeting. The concept of parliamentary procedures. Paano natin effectively mamanage itong munisipyo na to kung kulang din tayo sa kaalaman. Because, you know, we cannot blame them because they are there because they won in an election. But, you know, because kaalam nyo naman ang batas natin, for as long as you lead and write, okay na yun, di ba? But, you know, instead of blaming these guys, tuturuan na lang natin sila because yun yung swerte nila na nagiging local government officials, maximize na lang natin yung ARMM Local Government Academy, ibigyan ng training, i-improve yung, which include Islamic leadership doon sa module. So yun po ang plano namin as far as committee on local government.
Mabalik tamat to pa pag-assist kanila ha, technical know-how. There is a need for our local government chief executive to be well-versed with regards to administrative management, with assisting them in their technical know-how, the technical aspect of governance in their respective municipalities. Aside from that, the new crafted local government code, if passed, will somehow cater to the needs of our chief executive on matters of networking and linkaging. Ingatan mo, mataod umaasa ha mga local government officials ta ha ira. Doon na kayan ha local chief executive at tawa barangay chairman. Which is pilar ha. In other words, we really have to have a technical know-how for the benefit of these local government units. In order for them to survive their respective units, local government units, by means of networking with other foreign-assisted institutions, foreign-assisted project, because ayaw na sadya kita mangandol what is being provided by the national government. So, this is the essence of that ARMM Local Government Code. You see, based from experience, there is the so-called ARMM Local Government Academy, and there is also the existence of this Local Government Academy in Basin Manila. But sometimes the training institutions in Manila called for a seminar on leadership training, seminars on team building, seminars on administrative management, and that the participants coming from this local chief executive. But the modules is not consistent, or the modules is not adaptable in our area. Pasalan, in models in maghihinang sin mga module ini, amo na in model nila in Quezon City. Biarin kaingat nila in mga problema ha albarka. Because in mga tao humaghihinang module ini, way bisan makas nakakato papasilan. Or the model in Pata or Luuk in or Pandami in the province of Sulu. So these people are not familiar with what is really happening in our local government units in the area. So di magkugdan in modules in training nila bang hikadihil na maripa pa mga participants dahil nakato. Most especially, magbisara sila, bisara ang galis, English. So di resep kahatian sin kaibanan mga mayor. So what a waste of money, what a waste of time in attending this conference, utilizing public funds for their transport and registration in the seminars in the amount of 50 to 70,000, dukain pa yung pocket money, pag-usya to futile in training. Na dito isang problem in mga local government units because they are elected and they are mandated. But you know, there has to be an adjustment. This is the very reason bang maita na mo di-develop pa ARMM, labi luba na ha Regional Legislative Assembly in mga strategies, parameters, mangunin pa to i-develop supaya magmumpaat, supaya adjustable doon ha pagkalagihan sin mga local government units ta. yan in bahasa pagmaanahon sa pagnganan sinamon bago sarahin ang namo inya mo in ARM local government code in modules in training nila bang hikadihil na maripa pa mga participants day na kato most especially magbisara sila bisara ang galis English so di resep kahatian sin kay banan mga mayor. So what a waste of money, what a waste of time in attending this conference, utilizing public funds for their transport and registration in the seminars in the amount of 50 to 70,000, looking pa yung pocket money, pag-usya to utilize.